Hello friends, welcome to Global Tech Learn. In today's video, we will learn few SQL Server keywords like top, offset, fetch first, and fetch next. All these are the keywords used to limit the result set from the query in the SQL Server. So let's see all the keywords in SQL Server Management Studio. So I'm in SQL Server Management Studio now, and let's try to query data from any table. So for that, let's right select stuff from geography table, and here you can see we are getting 18 records from geography table. Now let's say if I want to limit the data from this table, in that case we can add top keyword over here, and then we have to provide how many records we want to see in result set. So let's say I want to see only top 10 records, and let's execute this statement. And here you can see we are getting only 10 records from the result set. Also, if we apply any grouping or order by on the result set, in that case the top 10 will apply on the top of result only. So for example, let me apply order by city, and let me remove top 10 for now. And now when I execute this statement, you can see we are seeing Calgary, Canmore, Chennai, Coimbatore, all these cities at the top because of order. So now if I want to limit this result set, then I can add top 10 over here, and let me execute this statement, and you can see we are getting top 10 cities after applying the order by. Now let's see the next keyword, that is offset. We can use offset when we want to skip records from the result set. So for that, let me remove top 10 for now, and let's execute this. And now here you can see at the top we are getting city Calgary, and thereafter we are getting Canmore. So let's see if I want to skip the Calgary or the first record from the result set, and then I want to get the rest of the results set. So for that I can add keyword offset, then how many rows I want to skip, so that is one, and then we have to provide the rows. Let's execute this statement. And here you can see the Calgary has gone and the result has started from Canmore itself. Now if I want to skip Canmore as well and I want to start from Chelm, then I can provide 2. And let's execute. And you can see the result set has started from Chelm and the first 2 record has gone. Also just make sure when we are using offset, the order by is mandatory. If we do not use the order by, then offset is not sure which records needs to be removed. So let me execute this statement, and this should throw error. And here you can see. So order by is mandatory with the offset, but order by is not mandatory with the top. So let me add top 10 records. Let me execute. And here you can see we are getting 10 records. Even though if I add order by, city, the top 10 will work with this. So this is a bit difference between offset and top that we have to keep in mind. Now let's move on to the fetch first. Fetch first is like top keyword only. Usually we use it with the offset. So let's go back to the offset. Let me add offset 2 rows, and here we have result set. And now after that we want to get first 3 rows only. For that we can add fetch first 3 rows only. So after applying this fetch first 3, we should get only first 3 cities, that is Chelm, Chennai and Coimbatore. So let's execute this, and here you can see we are getting Chelm, Chennai and Coimbatore. If I make it 5, I will get 5 cities or 5 top records after offset the first 2 rows. Now similar to first, we can use fetch next 5 records as well. It will also return the same result set. Now if I execute this, you can see we are getting same cities. So this is just the offset of 2 records, and after that fetch next 5 records. So with this you can see we can use top when we want to limit the result as per the top records from the result set, and we can use offset when we want to skip rows from the result set. And then we have fetch first and fetch next when we want to get the records from the result set after offsetting the rows. Also today I will ask you a question that you can answer in comments window. And the question is, a table needs to create with a numeric column that will be used as a unique row identifier. So which property we can configure while creating this table. We can use default identity, set primary key, sequence, or we can set the unique key on that column. You can attempt the answer in description window. I will provide heart to the correct answer so you can understand the correct answer for the question. So this is all for this video. If you have any question, you can post in a comment.